Hi folks, Peach Mario here, back with part 3, because there is one thing which I forgot with the element that we created. Now there is some text hard-coded inside the macro, and that's definitely not what we want. So we will remove all this stuff, so we can also make it a lot smaller. Because what we want is we want to call it, and then afterwards we use the reveal widget with the state, and then we use this state to check for open and close, or in this case is show and hide. So reveal widget, where is it? Widget, reveal widget, it says type match state and then text show. So sorry, type widget state match. State, it should match show, and it should default to close or closed. Oh, sorry, to hide. Default. Yeah, so when the state variable is missing, then it should hide or close. It depends on what you want to have. So reveal, this okay. Look, so hide. Oops, there is something missing. Not this one. But this one, this is the text. Okay, so and that's what we want to have. So we want to have a macro which is called TT in our case, and then somewhere else we can use the reveal widget with the match element, and we have to have the same state that we used here. Yeah, so now I hope we have everything which is needed, and as you can see, this open close or this hide show pattern is there very often, and that's why I try to simplify it. There is one thing which I don't like with this. Probably some of you know that I don't like hidden information. Yeah. And if the default is hidden, I don't like it, and it's also not good for screen readers. Yeah. So if we have users that use screen readers and we have hidden information where it is not obvious that there is hidden information, they just don't see it. Yeah. I think we should try to have as much of the content visible. Because if content is hidden, then yeah, it shouldn't be there. So that's my opinion. Yeah, then I hope you liked it. Have fun. Thank you very much.